Hi, so in this tutorial I'll show you how to quickly code an animal using my program zoozanne. First of all, you've got to select a base, so I'll use the ophthalmosaurus and enter a coding name. In an expansion pack, price. Without any currency symbol or whatever, or dots or commas, just plain numbers. Select the zoo fame and conservation status, the location, worldwide coasts, whatever, and the diet, chum and marine fish. I'm not sure if this will work with marine animals. So, I guess I'll have to expand this section, so I'll leave it empty for now. Might need to do this manually at the moment. And then we're done with general stuff, and then head over to Zoopedia and select the language you've got, you want to create a Zoopedia for. So let's say English and call it up here. There's the name, and then here down here you can enter the common names for class, order, and family, and to the right you can enter the scientific names. You can enter subspecies, you don't have to. When you enter facts, you go like this, fact 1, and such a paragraph with by hitting enter 2 times, so you've got a row, an empty row between, and then it's passed as 2 different facts. Okay, for the main text, you can write it in any way you like. So you can go like this, but you can also go like this. Doesn't really matter. It will be exactly the same in game. And here you can put, yeah, well, made by, whatever. And when you're done, click apply. And you can do that for as many languages as you wish, as long as they are supported. So now select another one and call it like this, whatever, and fill in the stuff. And when you're done, click apply. So when the Zoopedias are done, we can head over to the files tab and select the basic one and load a BFM. So I'll just take whatever brings me to. I'm not worrying about creating something useful at the moment. And remember, when you load a BFM, you always need a model associated with it. Otherwise, compiling will give you a bug. So give it a model and a texture, and didn't work. Okay, and the scale, when you use decimals, you don't want to put them with a comma, but use a dot. So just in case, always use a dot. And an icon. And when you're done, click apply. And so we'll want to make the baby smaller. So for this, we've got to load also BFM and the model. And then we can leave the text just blank, but put in a smaller scale. And that should be enough. Just to test. We don't have to do anything about tasks or behaviors. So those are really only if you want to do advanced coding, like with new animations and stuff. And you also don't really need those extra options unless you want to create custom animation, animals with custom animations. The last two are kind of useful. You can clear the animal library with the last one, or import whatever animal you like from a Zoo Tycoon file. And so now we're done. We can click on compile, and this will bring up the destination. And it by default puts it into the Zoo Tycoon 2 folder. And OK. And now you've got your animal done and compiled. And I hope that wasn't too hard. Should be quite easy. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed this and have fun creating animals.